Are you interested in how DNA works? Would you describe yourself as curious, persistent, and imaginative? Do you have a passion for improving human health, the environment, and farming? If you possess all these traits, you might have inherited the desire to be a geneticist. Geneticists study the structure, function, variability, and transmission of genes. They also study variations in chromosome sequences to identify, manipulate, or improve those sequences and how they express themselves biologically. We met with a geneticist working in Alberta who revealed some of the building blocks in this evolving career.
Hi, my name is Karen and I'm a geneticist. Geneticists study the structure, function, variability, and heritability, or transmission, of genes. I personally work with patients in the clinic and specialize in diagnosing people who have hereditary conditions to try and explain why they might have certain health problems. Some geneticists might work with animals or with plants that might require field work as well. Geneticists also study DNA variation to conduct research in clinical realms, medical realms, in forensics, evolutionary biology, and a variety of other fields. What I love about genetics is that there isn't really a typical day. There's a huge amount of variety. I see many different types of patients. Usually, I would say that most of my day is either seeing patients in the clinic or preparing to see patients in the clinic and taking part in various meetings. I might be teaching medical students or residents who come through the clinic or lecturing in the medical school. It's a huge variety. Because genetics is often dealing with very rare conditions, I can't necessarily just open a book and expect that I'm going to find an answer. It really is going to, well, what have other researchers around the world found and what is actually known about a specific condition.
And do you have any brothers or sisters?
I have two brothers and one sister.
As a geneticist, our appointments are probably a little bit different from your typical doctor's visit, because we're really needing to go into a lot of detail and collecting a history, any specific medical issues that might actually be very relevant to making a diagnosis. Then I will do an examination, and this is things like, you know, listening to the person's heart and examining their abdomen. But I also use my measuring tape a lot, and I'll do things like measuring the distance between people's eyes and looking at the creases on their hands to try and find any little clues or variations that can help me get to a diagnosis. Some of the skills that a geneticist might need, first and foremost, you have to be a really good communicator. I'd say the average geneticist spends a lot of time with patients and needing to be able to break down complex ideas and concepts. I think it's also really important to have curiosity and to be okay with not always knowing the answer. And then lastly, I think another really important characteristic is the ability to work in a team.
Just looking at your nails, that looks to be okay.
Most geneticists start their educational career in a four-year undergraduate program, such as a Bachelor of Science. A geneticist needs to have an advanced degree in genetics or in a related field, such as evolution, microbiology, or biochemistry. They may go on to do a Master's of Science or a PhD in genetics. All geneticists, regardless of how you enter the field, need to keep up with the latest research, as genetics is really a rapidly evolving field. What I would say to someone who's interested in becoming a geneticist is go for it. It is a fantastic field. It's very intellectually stimulating, and every day is different. It's not an area where I get bored and I'm constantly learning new things.
Geneticists use a mix of analysis, critical thinking, and imagination to find innovative solutions to problems. They get to use sophisticated equipment to perform their work and can work either individually or as part of a team. If you identify with this model, you might be the perfect specimen for this occupation. To learn more about this career, including training requirements and salary ranges, go to the occupational profile on the ALICE website. While you're there, check out related careers, such as biologist, agrologist, and biochemist. Explore the possibilities. Go to alice.alberta.ca.